Trey, bitch. Yes, your boy got J's out the asshole. Yes, your boy got J's out the asshole. Yes, your boy got. Yes, your boy got. Yes, your boy got. Yes, your boy got. Yes, your boy got J's out the asshole. I used to get them just to style on them and flash holes. And over the years, I done acquired mad souls. Had niggas like, damn, Dave, how long you had those?
Diamonds are forever. Diamonds are forever. Diamonds are forever. Diamonds are forever. They won't leave in the night. I've no fear that they might desert me. Diamonds are forever.
Throw your diamonds in the sky.
Trey Dave. And I know I've been talking about this video forever. So as promised, it is here. This is Dtroyt Dave's Air Jordan 12 Reshoot. Happy Father's Day. As y'all seen in the intro, I'm taking Yeezy pre-orders now. You're going to have to get with me ASAP because orders will be closing this Thursday. So get with me as soon as you possibly can if you want your pair of Zebras locked in. And I switched up the, I had pulled out a bunch of my sneakers, a bunch of my Heat sneakers, and took a video. So I switched it up just a little bit. I got DB5s and DB6s out now. Some of my favorite sneakers. Absolutely love them. But fuck all that. These are in order of release. Not necessarily in order of my favorites. I'm not sure which one is my favorite. But we'll find out. So, I used to have cherries. That's the only one we're not going to see. First up is a classic. I remember when this pair came out. In high school, they came out, I believe, right before the summer between 11th and 12th grade. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they did. I believe they came out May 1997 for the first time. They were retro in 2004 in the face box, team face box era. This is the 2012 release. Now, just a couple months ago, we also had a low top release, but I don't really buy low top 12s. It's just not my thing. So, here you have the Air Jordan 12 playoff, which probably is the most apparel friendly pair because playoff, you could literally put these on with anything. Jeans, sweats, shorts, t-shirts, polos, black jeans, blue jeans, it don't really matter. Now, I did put some work on these, and I actually bought them used, so I didn't really put the beats on them like that. But 12s are so durable, man. 12s are almost like the foamposite of the Jordan line. Like, you can really fuck around. My boy said, shout out to my boy said. My boy said, runs around and playoff 12s all of the time. And his probably look like about the same condition. You can really run around in 12s and they not really get messed up, man. You know? So these ones are actually starting to yellow because I've had them for a while. But like I said, man, definitely one of the more durable sneakers. And you can wear playoff 12s with everything, bro. It's really not too much you can't do with a playoff 12. Like I said, I don't really do the low tops, so I passed on the playoffs that dropped this year. And I never got the retro because at the time, I still had my original pair. If you guys been following me for a while, you know, like, that's like kind of the shoes that I brought out of that era with me. Like, I had all the OG 12s from when I actually had them in high school. So At the time, I didn't need them. But then I sold all of my 12s in like the summer of like 2011, I want to say, 2012. And then I went back and got them in 2013. So shout out to the playoff 12s. Now, this one may be my favorite. Matter of fact, it certainly is my favorite OG colorway. So I can say that this one is my favorite. And oddly enough, this was the pair that I missed in high school. I did not have this colorway in high school. Why? I can't even remember, man. Because normally back then I would get all the cherry colorways and all the Carolina colorways at the least when I was in high school. So why I didn't get them, I don't know. They dropped in February of 97 and have only been retro this one time. To me, it's a very, very dope sneaker. I take care of it. This is one I bought on release day. So coming up next, Air Jordan 12 Obsidian. That blue, man, the way those blues intermingle is just so dope to me. As you can see, took the original white laces out, threw some navy blue laces in that thing. Just because I think it's dope, man. I think it's dope. I just think the look is dope on that. It blends in perfectly. Shout out to my man, Payne 82. If you're not already subscribed to Payne 82, fuck with him. He's the king of lace swaps, the king of phone posits. And it's just another navy blue lace that I had. This one, for some reason, doesn't look as good to me. I think I like the white lace better. But I definitely like that lace the best, for sure, in these. Great sneaker. Absolutely love it. Absolutely love it. I don't really wear it that often. Take care of them guys, you know. Like I said, man, definitely my favorite colorway. I like the way that the blues blend. I just think they dope, man. I think it's a real nice look. And yeah, man, Obsidian 12s. Those are my guys right here. So shout out to the Obsidians. These released in April of 2012. These released in June, if I'm not mistaken, of 2012. Where they might have came out. No, because these came out before the Olympic Sixes. And the Olympic Sixes came out like 4th of July weekend-ish, somewhere around there. So I think, yeah, these were in June 2012. And then I wasn't fucking with too many more of the 12s that they had that year. As a matter of fact, what other 12s did they have that year? Was it the orange? It might have been the cool gray and orange 12s, I think, came out during that time as well. I wasn't fucking with them. So now you go all the way to 2013, which is why this is an 11, and those two are 10.5. 12s actually run pretty big, but by the time these came out, I just was buying 11 and everything. So everything you see that I have after 2013 pretty much is going to be a size 11. Actually, even a lot of my Jordans after 2010, 2011 are pretty much size 11. But this is the classic, man. Everybody loves this pair. They're rumored to be releasing again at the end of this year. So if they do, of course, you know how to pre-order up. But without further ado, man, fuck a Uber when you in a taxi. You know what I'm saying? Now, people fuck with the lace, man, and I'm very happy that they did. I was expecting people not to really get it. Why the fuck do you have this lace in that shoe? Funny story is that lace actually came from a pair of duck boots I bought my son. But people got it, man, and they fucked with it. Now, if you don't get it, the reason that I had that lace in there is because if you're familiar with the Taxi 12s, then you know under the sole, it has that print. So it kind of works out perfectly, you know? It's just a good look. I thought it was dope. I took the laces out of that sneaker boot that he had. Now, these are probably my best condition worn Jordans, Jordan 12s. Because you can see on the Obsidians is a little bit more creasing or whatever. But then again, I've only worn these sneakers one time. So, of course, they're going to look damn good. You know what I'm saying? Not my favorite. Never been my favorite. I remember when they first came out, I did not have them. I got them way later. I went back and got them on sale. I think I got them on sale after I got those. And I'm talking about in high school. Just wasn't a fan, really. I had just went back and got them because I got them for like 70 bucks or some shit like that. And, you know, it was still another Jordan. So I was like, fuck it, I'll do it. But Taxis have never really been my favorite. They cool. I fuck with them. I'll rock them. But never really been my favorite. But shout out to the Taxi 12, man. It's a lot of people fuck with it, you know. So, bam, Taxi 12s. Then they chilled out on 12s for a while. But when they brought them back in 2016, they gave us the OG style boxes. These are how the boxes looked in 97, although they were a lot smaller and they fit around the sneaker a lot more. These ones are just stupid big. Like, I have no idea why in the fuck they made these boxes this large. I have no clue. But this is going to be your 2016 run. So, like I said, we're in order. We're going from April 2012 to June 2012 to December 2013. Now we're jumping all the way to my birthday month last year. So, this is April 2016. This is a Retro Plus colorway that debuted in 2003, when they had first started to retro the Air Jordan 12. I didn't get it back then. I always liked it, but it just wasn't one of those shoes that I felt like I needed to have. So when they came back out, I didn't buy them. Also with the Flint Gray 12s, which now if Flint Gray 12s drop, I'm copping them first day. Flint Gray 12s is hard to me. But I just got this thing for charcoal sneakers or, you know, with dark gray colors in them. I don't know. But, I like them. So I copped them. Still haven't worn them this time, but people are really starting to beat theirs up now. So I could probably pull them out with confidence. Cause you know me, I don't really like wearing them when everybody's wearing them. That's why when I copped my 13s last week, I put them straight on foot. Cause a lot of people wasn't fucking with them. But for me, those are two of the most important sneakers. Them low top 13s right there. But you'll see more about those in the video next month. So anyway, without further ado, a Retro Plus colorway that made its return last year. Air Jordan 12, Frenchies. And like I said, at this moment, these are still DS. Have not worn them. But I definitely will be wearing them. They dope to me, man. I fuck with them. I fuck with them the long way. I'm actually really, really glad I got up here. First time we ever saw that sneaker was back in 03. Came in a face box as well. I think they really stood true to the original release as far as the level of tumbling on the leather. Because all the 12s got tumble leather. But this one, I think, was one of the first ones that the tumble really popped out at your ass. And so, yeah, man. Fresh blue 12s. Frenchies, like I said, I still haven't worn them. But I will wear them. I don't really have the itch to wear them this year. Like I was telling you in my previous video. I got the itch to wear a couple pairs, man. I got the itch to wear Poison Green 5s, a.k.a. Space Jam 5s. I got the itch to wear Fragments this year. So those sneakers are going to get undead stock. This one, I don't got the itch yet. So I'm cool with keeping these dead stock for another year or two or three. I mean, shit. These was dead stock for 10 years, and I just wore them the first time last weekend at a pool party. So, I have no problem with keeping sneakers dead stock until I feel like wearing them. But, you know. Frenchies, man. The only thing I don't like about the Frenchies, it seemed like even though the tumble leather looks good, the quality of them is not as good, man. Like, it kind of looked almost fake. It kind of looked cardboard. You see this line right here of, I don't even know why it's there. Like, the stitching doesn't go right there. There's no, like, understitch that goes right there. I don't know why. Well, I could be wrong. This leather is actually pretty fucking nice. I don't know. Maybe I'm tripping. But, yeah, man. French blue 12s. Like I said, I have not worn them yet. But I definitely plan on wearing them. It's just a dope little sneaker, man. It's kind of like a French blue, like Flint 13s, you know, so it's kind of that feel, not quite navy, but it's not as light as royal blue. It's kind of like that in between, and I think the sneaker is really dope, man. So there you go, French blue 12s. Now, when you come over here, now you getting back into that OG shit. Now you getting back into that shit that means a lot to those of us who've been doing this for a while. This is a dope sneaker. It's been immortalized. Immortalized. No, that means you're immortal. It's been immortalized. Mortal means you don't die. It's been immortalized. Immortalized. Excuse me. By the legendary game. So you already know what these is. They dropped last May. Flu games, bitch. Again, another sneaker I haven't worn yet because everybody and their mama got flu games, which I'm not mad. I had like 20-something pre-orders, so I helped a lot of people get this sneaker. So I'm actually part of the responsible party for so many people wearing them. Dope sneaker, man. Like I said, the flu game, the bread colorway is all black and red. Like, a lot of times on a bread sneaker, you'll have another color like white. You'll have gray on the fours. White on the midsole of the ones. But this is like truly a bread colorway. It's all black and red. As a matter of fact, I don't think there's any other color on the shoe at all besides black and red. So very, very, very dope sneaker. I fuck with them heavy. I mean, how could you like Air Jordan 12s and not fuck with the flu games? You know what I'm saying? But like me, I just haven't worn them yet. But very dope sneaker. You know, so these will be coming out pretty soon. I don't know, maybe this year, maybe not. I don't know. I just always wanted to wear them with like black jeans and a red sweatshirt. Like, I don't want nothing but black and red on. I don't know why. Just I'm crazy like that. But like I said, very iconic sneaker from the game. Black and red colorway was one of the dopest colorways at the time. So there you have it, man. And we got shit. 4 out of the 5 original colors. So, you know, we're not doing so bad. But now on to this one, though. This is the dopest general release colorway, period, to me. I think I pretty much like these better than the majority of these. Maybe Obsidians and these might be neck and neck. But this is a Retro Plus colorway, meaning we've never seen it before. I just think it's super dope. I actually just undead stocked one on vacation. Because I had on this like plaid outfit. The theme for the party was nautical. So I don't like these plaid golf shorts and this skipper shirt and all that. And I wore one of those Obsidians and one of these. So without further ado, the strawberries. My favorite 9OG colorway. The red and white. Which I think, like I say, was just a really, really dope sneaker. I think this is the one I wore. Yeah, this looked like the one I wore. I can't even tell because I cleaned them up real good. And I only wore it one time for like 4 hours. Let me see. Man, I can't tell. I wore one of them. I don't fucking know. It was probably... hold on. I can't tell. But I can't wait to put these on. I might fuck around and wear these again this year. These shit so motherfucking dope to me, man. And I call them the strawberries because obviously the cherries are the reverse of this. And I don't know. I just like making up cool nicknames like oil spills for my hologram phones. It's just a dope sneaker, man. To me, that shit fire, bro. Like, I don't know. It's just the color combinations, man. It's just I really like these 12s. I think they dope, man. So, yeah, these were the last release out of the generals that I got. And I got another pair, too, that we finna drop in a second. But they deserve their own spotlight. So, yeah, man, like I said, I wore one of them. This one probably still dead stock. So, I'm gonna rock them this year, man. But there you have it. Playoffs. April 2012, Obsidians, June 2012, Taxis, December 2013, French Blues, April 2016, Flu Games, May of 2016, Jim Reds, aka Strawberries, which came out July 2nd last year, right before the 4th. And I got one more Retro 12 that I'm about to pull up. So we'll be right back. Like what? I never left. And we back with my favorite Retro 12. As you can see, it's in a class by itself. And since you already know what that box is, I'm not even going to waste your time. What up, Drake? My last and very, very favorite, complete with the receipt, of course, Retro 12 ever created, the OVO. Now, I've got an affinity for white and gold sneakers, I've realized. The DMP pack was my favorite pack for a long time, really still is the best pack that was ever created, really. I mean, if you want to be real. The Golden Moments pack, a lot of people fuck with the 7s. I only wanted the 6. When I bought the whole pack, I only wanted the 6. I rocked the 7s just to give them kind of like a test run to see if I would fuck with them a little bit more. Because, you know, sometimes sneakers grow on a nigga. But they just didn't do it. I love those sneakers. I've worn them maybe about 6 times, keep them in pristine condition. So those look damn near dead stock. Even if these were not affiliated with Drake, because I know a lot of people fuck with the hype. Even if these were not affiliated with Drake, even if this was a general release, even if it didn't have a stingray on the side, I would still have gone crazy for a white and gold 12. These shits is fucking dope to me. So, you know, buy what you like, man. Sometimes I do fall for the hype. I'm not going to front. But this is not that. These shits, man, just hold on. Sometimes you just got to look at them, bro. You just gotta pause for a minute and chill. And just, come on, man. I undead stocked these on vacation. Killed the club with them, man. Literally killed the club with them. Dope Air Jordan 12, man. The leather quality, I like the off-white, you know what I'm saying? Like, not the clothing label, I'm saying. Like, I like the cream, and then it still got the white, and then the stingray. Like the stingray right here with the fucking gold. Oh man, come on, bro. And it got that same little boxy look too, like the motherfucking French blues. I don't know what's up with that. But these shits is dope, man. The only thing I think that would have made this shoe better is if they would have made this box around a Jumpman gold, and if they would have made that 23 gold and the writing gold. Other than that, phenomenal. Love the sneaker. So happy to have it. So here you are. To complete Dtroyt Dave's Air Jordan 12 reshoot. The OVO 12. Which is my favorite Retro 12. I know I've been talking about this video for a long time. I was really trying to wait until the cherries came back out. Because I sold my cherries. So if I'm doing a whole reshoot, I wanted to have all of them included. But they bullshitting. Them shits was supposed to be coming out for like the last 2 years. I'm not waiting on them shits no more. I ain't want y'all to wait no more. Air Jordan 12 reshoot is in the books. Upcoming videos. Of course, you know, I'm going to try to do it 4th of July weekend. But it might be a little bit after. I'm letting you know off top. Because, you know, I try to drop these around holidays. Because I know y'all going to be at the crib. You know what I mean? I know you're going to be off work. You're going to need something to watch. So, you know, that's why I gave y'all the last video, Memorial Day. That's why I'm giving you this one, Father's Day. And I wanted to give you the other one on 4th of July. Plus, I got some other things I want to start doing in July. I kind of want to hit y'all with something weekly, man. But, you know, depends on how my schedule is. Because, you know, my son coming down for vacation and all type of stuff going on. So, you know, it just depends on how busy I am. But I really want to try to get y'all some different stuff. Air Jordan 13 reshoot. I got to give it to y'all. The Air Jordan 13 reshoot is coming because I got all of my 13s. You know what I'm saying? I got all of my 13s, so I got to give y'all that reshoot. That's coming soon. And I think I'm just going to get into Reflections, man. Reflections is a new series that I'm thinking about doing where I just grab a sneaker and I just talk about it, man. I just talk to you about what I was doing when it came out, the reason why I got it, maybe if I had to camp for it, maybe if I've been searching for it, shit like that. It's just called Reflections, and we just going to talk about that one shoe. Like, y'all know me. I've been wanting to be different since I got on here. You know what I mean? So then I created the Step Your Motherfucking OG Game Up series. which really got my numbers up. Then I created the educational series, What is Heat? Evolution of the Box, for the next generation to say, okay, I didn't realize that Jordan had these many boxes. You know what I'm saying? I did that. I was the OG king, giving y'all all these different original videos. Now I'm a pre-order plug. I always want to keep building, want to keep growing. You know what I mean? Speaking of the pre-order plug, I got a question for y'all. Y'all know that I specialize in pre-ordering sneakers, right? Like y'all seen the Zebras. Holler at me now. Matter of fact, there's the number. 678-830-6690. To order your Zebras or anything else that's coming out, because there's a bunch of more stuff coming out. The Pippins coming out the week after that. It's just a bunch of stuff dropping. So holla at me. The Red Suede. Now, they're not going to be Toros. They're not going to be those. But they're going to be damn close to it. So, you know, those will be, I'll be pre-ordering those. But I am the pre-order plug. Like, this is what I do. So, if I was to create some t-shirts, would y'all fuck with me? I'm thinking about doing like a giveaway at first, maybe for the first 10 shirts. I think I'll do like a giveaway. If you pre-order with me, you'll get a shirt for free. I might do a giveaway through a video, like maybe two or three of those. But after that, man, I'm thinking like maybe $20, you know what I mean, for a pre-order plug t-shirt. I'm coming up with a dope concept. I'm talking to some people right now, getting that together. But as far as support, would you be able to do $20 for a Dtroyt Dave pre-order plug t-shirt? Let me know in the comments below. It's something I'm thinking about. Anyway, I appreciate it. I know this is one of my shorter videos, only like 30 minutes long. But this is what I got for you, man. So like I said, happy Father's Day. I know I'm a father. Happy Father's Day to all the other fathers out there. Once again, shout out to my man Payne82. If you're not already subscribed to him, subscribe to him. This man is doing different things with his channel. I was there from the beginning. We talk on a regular basis. Well, not really as much lately, but he's still my man's. The king of phone posits, the king of lace swaps. This man is giving you insight into his life. He giving you a sneaker rotation. He's showing you his wife's collection. They hitting sneaker shows all over the country. So please subscribe to my man Payne82 video. He's also a father, so I'm going to have to shout out to him. Happy Father's Day. And I just appreciate y'all support, man. Like I said, next month, I'm going to be starting to do some different things. I'm going to kick it off with my second quarter cops, which is going to be a fire one. You're going to like it. And then we're going to go from there, man. So like I said, once again, I appreciate it. And it's your boy, Dtroyt Dave.
Get back.